Well, NASA has made plenty of history with space flights to Mars, but today, a new chapter. It flew on Mars for the very first time. Miles O'Brien takes us out of this world.
Altimeter data confirms that Ingenuity has performed its first flight.
When the data and the early images came down, proving history was made 180 million miles away, the Mars Ingenuity team erupted with joy. Project manager Mimi Ong ripped up the contingency speech she wrote in case things did not go as well as they did. Ingenuity took off, hovered, and landed on Mars, the first powered, controlled flight on another planet.
We can now say that human beings have flown a rotorcraft on another planet.
Mars changes the equation for flight with wings or rotors. The gravity is about one-third of Earth's, and the carbon dioxide atmosphere is much thinner.
It's about 1% compared to here, right, on Earth. Even though you're able to lift, right, you have to spin very fast to lift. Because the atmosphere is so thin, you can't lift as much mass.
Here on Earth, helicopter blades typically spin about 300 or 400 revolutions per minute. Ingenuity's blades spin about 8 times faster, 2,400 RPMs. The key challenge for the team, make the helicopter as small and light as possible to fit on Perseverance and to be flight-worthy. To find compact components, they didn't have to look much farther than their own smartphones.
The advancement of these cellular phone technologies and also, you know, autonomous cars are also starting to have, you know, reliable, lightweight sensors, right? And there are lightweight computers on the phones and, you know, drone community has also advanced electronic components.
Ingenuity is a technology demonstrator, so its goals are modest. The plan is to fly only 5 flights, no higher than 15 feet, no farther than 160 feet downrange, and no longer than a minute and a half. If history serves as a guide, Ingenuity could usher in a new era of mobile exploration on Mars.
We have imaging data.
Yes.
In 1997, the first Mars rover, Sojourner, was also a technology demonstration project. The size of a microwave oven, it led to larger and more capable successors. Spirit and Opportunity in 2003, Curiosity in 2012, and now Perseverance. Lori Glaze is director of NASA's Planetary Science Division.
The helicopters can actually help to do reconnaissance, to scope out a new site, or actually to access places that we can't actually access, to collect samples potentially, or carry scientific instrumentation to do some in-situ science from the helicopters.
Just as it was 118 years ago at Kitty Hawk, this first flight is likely just the beginning of a new era of aviation. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Miles O'Brien.